From a bird's eye view, matter looks rigid and its properties easily measurable. But even a six-year-old knows that his carefully engineered sandcastle is the sum of billions of tiny sand grains. The next question becomes, what makes up a sand grain? As some may know, the next level down is the atom. The concept of atoms was first proposed by the Greeks, who believed that objects could be indefinitely split into halves until you were left with a single, indivisible speck of matter. This unimaginably small unit could not be divided further and was therefore called an atom, which roughly translates to non-cuttable. However, it took almost two millennia for the atom to be recognized as our fundamental physical object. This long-standing speculation was finally confirmed in the 1800s, when chemist John Dalton conducted a series of ingenious experiments that found the average diameter of an atom to be around 50 nanocentimeters, 1/1,000,000th the size of a grain of sand. The atom was thus the smallest thing known to man. Of course, that was only until 1897, when Sir J.J. Thompson discovered something even more fundamental, the electron. An electron's average diameter turned out to be 0.00000000001 centimeters, or 2,000 billion times smaller than a grain of sand. When Rutherford, another titan in his field, bombarded a thin piece of gold foil with alpha rays, he discovered that atoms were mostly empty, but contained a concentrated positive central charge. He called this center the atom's nucleus, and named the positively charged particle protons. However, chemists soon discovered isotopes, elements that are chemically indistinguishable but differ in their atomic masses. It seemed that a pair of isotopes contained the same number of protons but still exhibited a difference in their overall mass. Rutherford accounted for this by suggesting the presence of a new fundamental particle, slightly heavier than a proton but electrically neutral. His speculation came true when James Chadwick discovered this laconic particle, the neutron. The quest to find particles even more elementary than electrons, protons, and neutrons led humanity to construct particle accelerators. These accelerators smash subatomic particles at enormous speeds, which causes them to shatter into their constituent parts. When physicists first began colliding electrons with protons, they observed that electrons bounced off three small, hard cores inside the proton. These cores were found to be even smaller particles that make up each proton. These elementary particles are called quarks. So, can we dig any deeper? No, at least not yet. Quarks are the smallest entities we have come across in our scientific endeavor through the sand grain. Actually, quarks and electrons. You see, unlike its peers, the electron has resisted being further broken down into more elementary pieces. However, if electrons and quarks are fundamental, and quarks reside in protons, how is its radius three times larger than that of a proton? Using these ratios, we find the radius of an electron to be around 10 times smaller than we previously thought, a billionth of a billionth of a centimeter. Researchers haven't had any luck with quarks either. They refuse to be isolated, and even if they are, they don't last too long. Some live as little as 1/1,000,000,000th of a billionth of a billionth of a second. Still, scientists have managed to conduct some shrewd studies to approximate the size of a quark. The latest approximation is about 1/1,000,000,000th of a billionth of a centimeter, very similar to an electron. Clearly, scientists have pushed as far as our technology allows, but the search for an ultimate fundamental particle might never end.